As your bot cleans, he simultaneously maps his surroundings, and the app shows the map being built in real time. At the end of a cleaning run, you can see a map of the space your bot was able to clean. You'll also see areas where the bot found furniture, as well as obstacles he noticed on his way. To view the map, click the map icon in the bObsweep app. The charging station icon shows where the station is located within the map. Your bot identifies different rooms as he finds them in the house, and colors each of them with a unique color. The lighter areas on the map show furniture lines, clutter, and other obstacles he finds on his cleaning journey. Your bot best learns when he explores at various times of the day. This way, he sees different sunlight and artificial light patterns and shadows, as well as different people and pet patterns. Keeping doors open and the floors free of clutter help the bot to reach every part of your home to navigate it smoothly. If you notice your bot getting stuck anywhere, take note of the location so later you can make adjustments to the map and add no sweep zones to keep your bot from getting stuck in those areas. After a full clean is done and a map of the house is generated, open the bObsweep app and review the map. You can rotate the map in 90-degree increments using the Rotate button on the screen. Set your preferred orientation using the Rotate button. This will become your default view each time you open the map. You can also zoom in and out using a two-finger pinch. If the map your bot made looks difficult for you to follow, try editing the map so your bot can see your home the way you would like him to. Once the map is edited to your liking, try saving it. This way, you can always retrieve it in case the app's live map ever gets distorted or lost. We will show you how to save your map at the end of this video. After your bot is done with cleaning and is back at his charging station, you can review and edit the map. The map cannot be modified while your bot is actively cleaning. You can, however, pause the bot if you need to make a quick edit. To edit the map, while in map view, click the Edit icon, a closed toolbox, to view the Map Edit toolbox. A menu will appear on the left side of your screen. The toolbox allows you to draw no sweep zones to keep the bot away from certain areas, divide rooms that are shown as one, connect rooms that are shown as separate, add room labels such as kitchen or living room, add no mop areas to keep mopping bots away from certain areas while their mop is attached. Note that non-mopping bots do not have this map feature. Erase the map and send your bot for a swift map. To exit the menu, click the open toolbox on the bottom left of the map. Divide rooms. If your bot has colored two or more rooms as one large room, or if you want to partition any room for any reason, use this feature to divide the space into as many rooms as you like. Note that connecting and dividing rooms will remove any existing room labels on the map. Select Divide Rooms on the Map Edit Toolbox. Tap anywhere on the map to add a room divider. Resize, rotate, and drag the divider to place it in the desired spot. Once in the right spot, tap on the divider and use the pop-up menu to save or delete the divider. Give the app a few seconds to complete the process and new colors will appear. Repeat to add more dividers or tap back to return to the map edit toolbox. Connect rooms. If you would like to connect two rooms into a larger room, or if your bot has partitioned a room incorrectly, use this feature to connect adjacent spaces into a larger room. From the map edit toolbox, select connect rooms. Tap any two adjacent rooms that you'd like to connect. Choose Connect on the pop-up menu to complete. Within a few seconds, the app will refresh and spaces will be connected. If you would like to connect more spaces, repeat these steps or hit back to return to the Map Edit toolbox. Add room labels. Next in the map review process is assigning names or labels to your rooms. This will especially come in handy later when you're trying to create a customized cleaning schedule. From the Map Edit toolbox, select Add Room Labels. Tap the room you would like to label and scroll through a list of room names to find the best match. Within a few seconds, the app will refresh and show the room's name and icon. If you decide to update or delete a room's label, tap the icon in that room and use the pop-up menu to edit or delete the room's label. Note that if you delete room labels, your saved cleaning schedules can be affected. That is why the app will not allow updating a label if the room is being used in an active schedule. To avoid this, first update the schedule or delete it, then return to make modifications to a room's label. Draw no sweep areas. No sweep zones are helpful tools because they help keep your bot away from areas in the house where your bot either should not or cannot navigate. These can be areas with loose wires or small objects that can be picked up but shouldn't, or areas where the bot can repeatedly get stuck. The app supports two types of no-sweep areas. No-sweep zones, where you will draw a rectangular area that your bot should not enter, and no-sweep lines, where you will draw a line that your bot should not cross. To draw a no-sweep zone or line, tap on the map where you want to add the no-sweep zone or line. A red rectangle will appear on the map. Resize and move to place the zone on the map where desired. Then tap on the zone to save, delete, or change the zone into a line, and vice versa. You can also tap away from the zone to close the pop-up menu and continue editing. Repeat to create up to 10 no-sweep zones or lines on the map. To return to the map edit toolbox, hit back. Add no-mop areas. No-mop areas are parts of the map that your bot will not enter if his mop is attached. This feature only applies to mopping bots. To create a no-mop area, choose Add No-Mop Areas from the menu. Tap the map where you want to place your no-mop area. Drag to resize, modify, or move to the desired location. Tap to save or delete the area. You can also tap away from the zone to close the pop-up menu and continue editing. Repeat to draw up to a total of 10 no-mop areas. Erase the map. Sometimes the map can become distorted. This can be from making changes to your furniture layout or even moving to a new home. To erase the map, select the Erase Map icon from the Map Edit toolbox. You will be asked to confirm the delete. Once you confirm, the map will be erased. Note that your saved schedules, room labels, and other map data will also be erased. Swift mapping. If you'd rather not wait for your bot to clean the entire floor while mapping the space, you can select Swift Map. This option allows the bot to simply map the area without cleaning. If the map looks significantly different from your floor plan, it may be best to delete said map and have your bot remap the house from scratch. This is often much faster than manually updating the map. Make sure your bot is sufficiently charged, doors are open, and floors are free of clutter to help him reach every part of your home and navigate it smoothly. Your bot will return to his charging station after he's done mapping. Save the map. Over time, your bot's map may edit itself as the bot learns about new landmarks and notices unused areas. Sometimes, changes in the environment can also cause distortions. To avoid losing the map you just edited and modified to your liking, it is best to save it. To save the map, tap the drop-down menu icon on top of the map page. Tap the Add icon below the active map. If prompted, give the map a name and continue. The map will save into the first available slot. Your bot can save up to 3 maps at a time. These can be maps of up to 3 floor levels of your home or 3 versions of the same floor map, each with different customizations and modifications. To use a saved map as the active map, first, tap the drop-down menu icon on top of the map page. Then tap the map you want your bot to use. Tap Load Map. A pop-up will appear to confirm you would like to switch your bot's active map to the selected map. If a map becomes corrupted or distorted for any reason, or if you accidentally erase the active map, your saved maps can be used as the active map. For additional help using the bObsweep app, contact our helpful support team.